Welcome to SSLC Social Science Revised Textbook Videos. In this video, let us see additional questions with the answers of Chapter 18, The Freedom Struggle. What were the objectives of Indian National Congress? To kindle the patriotic feelings of Indians, to publish papers in the local languages, to start debates on political problems, to create awareness among the people on political situation and its problems, to formulate positive plans of action related to national issues. Who were moderate leaders? Explain their method of struggle. Traditionally, the first 20 years of the beginning of Congress are called the modern age. M.G. Ranade, Surendranath Banerjee, Dadabhai Nauroji and Gopal Krishna Gokhale were prominent leaders. They trusted the British administration and their impartiality. They used to place their requests and appeals before the government within the constitutional framework. They taught people about political situation. They conducted meetings, discussed problems and placed before the government. Explain the method of struggle of extremists. They called the moderates as political beggars. Those who criticized the moderate thinking and propagated extremist ideas were known as extremists. Arvind Ghosh, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bipin Chandra Pal and Bala Gangadhar Tilak were the prominent extremist leader. Extremists maintained that good administration cannot be a substitute for independence. Tilak declared, "Swaraj is my birthright and I will get it at any cost." An independent India was the aim of extremists. They started preparing the common people for freedom struggle through religious functions. They started organizing people for a freedom movement. Lokmanya Tilak utilized his Kesari and Marathi and Maratha newspaper in English for freedom struggle. Explain the role of revolutionaries in freedom struggle. The revolutionaries dreamt of a totally free India. They strongly believed that the British could be thrown out of India only by violent means. They started establishing their secret branches in India and abroad and engaged in collection of money, arms and training of people. Anushilana Samiti and Abhinava Bharata were important organizations of this kind. They used bombs and firearms to achieve their objectives. The government tried their best to suppress them. The revolutionaries were arrested for murder attempts. They were declared guilty and given life imprisonment. What were the reasons for the partition of Bengal? Bengal was the center of protests and anti-British sentiments. In order to curb this, Viceroy Lord Curzon proposed a plan to divide Bengal, citing administrative problems. East and West Bengal, based on Muslims and Hindu population, were created. Thus, by creating differences between the two communities, they tried to reduce the intensity of freedom struggle. Describe the struggle against the partition of Bengal. Extremists opposed the partition of Bengal. Protests started mounting throughout the country against the division of Bengal. The Swadeshi movement was very important among these protests. Swadeshi movement called for a ban on Western goods and the organization supporting the import of European items. They encouraged the people to use Indian goods. Describe the achievements of Gaidin Lu. Gaidin Lu collected ladies of northeastern India and joined Jadunang to fight the British. She joined the Heraka religious movement along with Jadunank. She took charge of the army and led the movement against the British. In just 8 months, the British were taken aback. She fought on the lines of guerrilla warfare. The entire villages of Northeast cooperated. Thousands of people joined her army. Some of the traitors gave information about her to the British. MacDonald, who was against her, got information from Dr. Harlow and imprisoned her. She was in jail till India became free. What were the main tactics followed by Mahatma Gandhi in the freedom struggle? Indirect protests, non-violence, Satyagraha, the newspaper, Young India. When and why Rowlatt Act was enacted? The Rowlatt Act was enacted in 1919. The British government brought into force many regulations with a view to suppress the increasing revolutionary activities. This act gave the judges power to arrest and interrogate people based on mere suspicion. Explain Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Punjab witnessed widespread protests against Rowlatt Act. The protesters had decided to assemble at Jallianwala Bagh. About 20,000 protesters had assembled in the demonstration against the Rowlatt Act. This peaceful demonstration was in progress in high-walled Jallianwala Bagh, which had narrow entrances. General Dyer arrived at this place without any previous warning with his army and attacked the protesters from all sides with firearms. In this massacre, about 379 people died and thousands suffered serious injuries. Explain the Khilafat movement. Ali brothers started the Khilafat movement in India in order to support the Turks. Gandhiji believed that only if Hindus and Muslims fought together against the British would leave the country. In this context, he felt that participation of Muslims in the Congress was vital. Hence, Gandhiji declared his support to the Khilafat movement. This turned out to be a joint Hindu-Muslim nation wide movement against the British. Many national leaders and the Congress took active part in the Khilafat movement. What were the major programs of non-cooperation movement? Gandhiji gave a call for non-cooperation movement against the British. Students supported his call by abstaining from schools and colleges. Lawyers remained away from courts. Indian dignitaries returned all the awards given by the British. Motilal Nehru and C.R. Das sacrificed their law careers. During this period, there was a stiff opposition to the visit of the British prince. There were widespread agitations against the visit throughout the country. Who were the founders of Swaraj Party? What is its purpose? Motilal Nehru and C.R. Das established Swaraj Party with an intention of contesting elections in the future. Through this party, they wanted to enter the legislative assembly and oppose the policies of the British from within. Why was the Simon Commission appointed? Why did the Congress oppose it? The British government appointed the Simon Commission to examine the impact of 1919 Act, suggest suitable changes if needed, and submit it to the government. This commission did not have a single Indian as the member. Treating it as an insult to India, the Congress boycotted the Simon Commission. Write a note on Lahore Congress session. In the year 1929, under the presidentship of Jawaharlal Nehru, a Congress session was held in Lahore. During this conference, the Congress declared that Purna Swaraj was their aim. On January 26, 1930, the Congress celebrated Independence Day all over the country and supported the Lahore Declaration. This conference entrusted the responsibility of organizing the civil disobedience movement to Gandhiji. Explain the civil disobedience movement. Gandhiji, after assuming the leadership of civil disobedience movement, submitted a charter of 11 demands to Viceroy Irwin. He had conveyed that if these demands were not met, he would start civil disobedience movement. But Irwin did not consider Gandhiji's demands. As a result, Gandhiji travelled from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi in Surat on foot with his followers to produce salt in the seashore. In this manner, he started the civil disobedience movement. Many leaders of civil disobedience movement were arrested. This agitation spread to many parts of the country. Explain the Quit India movement. The suggestions of Crisp Commission were not acceptable to Congress. The Congress started the Quit India movement. Gandhiji gave a call to the Indians to do or die. In this context, many leaders like Gandhiji, Nehru and others were imprisoned. Since most of the Congress leaders were in jail, organizations other than the Congress came into the limelight. The movement paved the way for the emergence of new leaders. Jayaprakash Narayan assumed leadership of the movement. Explain farmers' protests in India's freedom struggle. During the British rule, farmers in many places revolted against landlords and European planters. They refused to grow indigo in Champaranya district. They staged agitations against land tax. Gandhiji had influence over the activities of farmers in Champaranya, Kheda and other areas. The farmers who were oppressed in the areas of Tebag, Malabar, etc. rose in revolt against landlords and the British. Many protests were organized under the banner of Kisan Sabha. The Telangana farmers revolted. Telangana farmers revolt challenged the Andhra Reddy landlords and the Nizam's Razak. Bengali farmers revolted against the exploitation by landlords. In Maharashtra, the farmers protested against low wages. Explain the laborers' revolt in India's freedom struggle. The labor movement started in Calcutta. People started getting organized to fight for their rights in jute and textile industries and the railways. The railway porters staged agitation in railway stations by shouting slogans and demanded higher wages from the British officials. The Printers Union of Calcutta and the Bombay Textile Workers created national awareness. The Madras Labour Union was established. Subsequently, many labour unions were born. The Congress supported these movements of the labour organization. Explain the contributions of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He strongly believed that political independence was meaningless without social independence. He did not see India as only a non-living political entity, but as one which had a living side too, with feelings and emotions too. He carried out a study of the caste system and came up with a plan to eradicate it. He started Mahatma and Kalaram temple movements. He attended the three roundtable conferences and gave valuable suggestions. He established an organization, Bahishkruta Hitakarini Sabha, and two separate parties named Swatantra Karmika Party and Republican Party of India. He published various newspapers like Prabuddha Bharata, Janata, Mukanayaka and Bahishkrita Bharata. He stayed away from communist and socialist approaches and worked towards progress of agricultural laborers. He was unanimously chosen as the chairman of the Constitution Draft Committee. He advised equality in the Constitution and gave legal protection against practice of untouchability. After independence, he became the Law Minister of India. Describe the contributions of Jawaharlal Nehru to the country as Prime Minister. We see Prime Minister Nehru as the architect of industrialization and modern India. He also supervised to bring together all the princely states and merge them with the Union of India. He laid the foundation for Indian democracy by reorganizing all the states on the basis of language, a mixed economic system which had principles of both capitalism and socialism was his contribution to modern India. He believed that growth was possible through intense industrialization. He was the pioneer who envisaged the development of India through 5-year plans. He advocated non-alignment policy on the basis of Panchashila principles. He remained away from power politics. Write a note on Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Muhammad Ali Jinnah worked as private secretary to Dadabhai Nauroji. He defended Tilak in court cases where he was accused of provoking unrest, and this brought him great appreciation. He joined Home Rule League movement. He spoke about the need for unity between Hindus and Muslims. Since he was being seen as a pro-Muslim politician, he opposed the British legacy. Condemning the Rowlatt Act, he resigned from his post in the Central Legal Advisory Committee. He declared that he was a nationalist Muslim in the roundtable conferences. As the days of declaration of freedom for India neared, he intensified his demand for Pakistan in many ways. He was successful in dividing the nation during the time of independence. Explain the process of partition of India. Throughout the freedom struggle, the Congress supported a united India. The Muslim League, on the other hand, kept on demanding a nation for Muslims. Jinnah declared that Hindus and Muslims could never form a country. The Labour Party sent a cabinet mission to have talks with India about self-rule. A difference of opinion arose between the Congress and Muslim League with reference to formation of interim government. The Muslim League gave a call to observe Direct Action Day. Due to this, widespread communal riots took place throughout the country. The Muslim League did not participate in the Constituent Assembly. The British government, declaring that it would transfer power soon, sent Lord Mountbatten as Viceroy of India. Mountbatten had talks with Gandhiji, Jinnah and others and framed a plan to divide India. On 15th August 1947, two nations named India and Pakistan came into existence.